Hello everyone, this is Animal Farm, Chapter 2, Episode 2. Their most faithful disciples were the two cart horses, Boxer and Clover. These two had great difficulty in thinking anything out for themselves, but having once accepted the pigs as their teachers, they absorbed everything that they were told and passed it on to the other animals by simple arguments. They were unfailing in their attendance at the secret meetings in the barn and led the singing of beasts of England with which the meetings always ended. Now, as it turned out, the rebellion was achieved much earlier and more easily than anyone had expected. In the past years, Mr. Jones, although a hard master, had been a capable farmer, but of late he had fallen on evil days. He had become much disheartened after losing money in a lawsuit and had taken to drinking more than was good for him. For whole days at a time, he would lounge in his Windsor chair in the kitchen, reading newspapers, drinking, and occasionally feeding Moses on crusts of bread soaked in beer. His men were idle and dishonest, the fields were full of weeds and buildings wanted roofing, the hedges were neglected, and the animals were underfed. June came and the hay was almost ready for cutting. On Midsummer's Eve, which was a Saturday, Mr. June went into Willingdon and got so drunk at the Red Lion that he did not come back till midday on Sunday. The men had milked the cows in the early morning and then had gone for rabbiting without bothering to feed the animals. When Mr. Jones got back, he immediately went to sleep on the drawing room sofa with the news of the world over his face so that when evening came, the animals were still unfed. At last they could stand it no longer. One of the cows broke in the door of the store, shed with her horn, and all the animals began to help themselves from the bins. It was just then Mr. Jones woke up. The next moment he and his foremen were in the store, shed with whips in their hands, lashing out in all directions. This was more than hungry animals could bear. With one accord, though nothing of the kind had been planned beforehand, they flung themselves upon their tormentors. Jones and his men suddenly found themselves being butted and kicked from all sides. The situation was quite out of their control. They had never seen animals behave like this before, and this sudden uprising of creatures whom they were used to thrashing and maltreating just as they chose frightened them almost out of their wits. After only a moment or two, they gave up trying to defend themselves and took to their heels. A minute later, all five of them were in full flight down the cart track that led to the main road, with the animals pursuing them in triumph. Mrs. Jones looked out of the bedroom window, saw what was happening, hurriedly flung a few possessions into a carpet bag, and slipped out of the farm by another way. Moses sprang off his perch and flapped after her, croaking loudly. Meanwhile, the animals had chased Jones and his men out on to the road and slammed the five-barred gate behind them. And so almost before they knew what was happening, the rebellion had been successfully carried through. Jones was expelled and the manor farm was theirs. For the first few minutes, the animal could hardly believe in their good fortune. Their first act was to gallop in a body right around the boundaries of the farm, as though to make quite sure that no human being was hiding anywhere upon it. Then they raced back to the farm buildings to wipe out the last traces of Jones' hated dream. The harness room at the end of the stables was broken open. The bits, the nose rings, and the dog chains, the cruel knives with which Mr. Jones had been used to castrate the pigs and lambs, were all flung down the well. The reins, the halters, the blinkers, the degrading nose bags were thrown onto the rubbish fire which was burning in the yard. So were the whips, and all the animals capered with joy when they saw the whips going up in flames. Snowball also threw onto the fire the ribbons with which the horses' manes and tails had usually been decorated on market days.